Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's program, we are going to reverse a number in Java. So for example, if the user is going to input a number, say 345, the output should be the reverse number, which is equal to 543. Okay, this is the program for that particular how to reverse a number. So we have a class digit number, and here I'm having two variables, num to accept the number from the user. When I say enter a number, num is equal to sc.nextint, and rev to store the reverse number. For this we use a while loop, while num not equal to 0, and we are going to extract each digit of the number. This complete explanation of this part I have given in one more video, how to extract the digits individually. But here if you observe, in the second line we have reverse is equal to reverse into 10 plus digit. So this is the change that we are going to make to get the entire reverse number instead of individual digits. So num is equal to num by 10 and system.out.println reverse number. So let us look at the program logic. So here again we have two variables here, which I told you earlier, and here if you observe, when the mod operator is used we get the remainder, and when a division operator is used we get the quotient. So we have taken here the example as num is equal to 345. Okay, so let us look at the steps of the while loop. Num is equal to 345. While num not equal to 0, digit is equal to num mod 10, and reverse is equal to reverse into 10 plus digit. See, the earlier program had asked you to just print the digit, but here we have made a small change. Num is equal to num by 10. So let us go to the steps. So I have num is equal to 345. So while now 345 is not equal to 0. So 345 is definitely not equal to 0. So digit is equal to 345 mod 10. So this step I have shown here. So when you divide 345 by 10, we get 5 as the remainder. And here we are going to extract the last digit. So it will be initially the value of REV is 0. You can see here REV is equal to 0. So we have 0 there. So we are going to multiply that by 10. 0 into 10 plus 5. Now we get the value 5. Now we have to, so this last digit is extracted. Now we have to extract this digit 4. So for that, we are again going to take this number 345 and now do an integer division for it by 10. So when we do the integer division, we have to take this quotient, which is 34. So this 34 is what I have written here. So the value of num has become 34. Now again it goes into the while loop. 34 is not equal to 0, and then we do 34 mod 10. So please see here the step 2. So 34 mod 10 will give 4 as the remainder and 3 as the quotient. So digit is equal to 4, and reverse is what? The earlier 5. It is 5 now. 5 into 10 plus 4, which will give me 54. So already I have got these two digits. Okay, so the third thing I have to do, I have to get this value 3. So again it is going to enter into the while loop, because num has not become equal to 0. So 34 mod 10 is how much? It gives you 3. Okay, so the value of num has now become 3. While 3 is not equal to 0, digit will be 3 mod 10. So I have explained in detail how I am getting this remainder 3 in my previous video. Please watch that. Digit is equal to 3 mod 10, which will give me the value 3. Now reverse is equal to 54 into 10, which is this 54. This is multiplied by 10 here. That is 540 plus this digit, which is equal to 3. So I am getting the reverse as 543. So 345 has become 543. Now what happens to num? Num is 3 by 10. 3 integer division by 10. So that gives me 0 as the quotient. So num is equal to 0. So here num has become 0. So 0 is not equal to 0. That means 0 is equal to 0. So this particular thing is false, the statement. So the loop stops. Okay, and then we are going to print this value 543. So this is how the logic of the program is. Hope you understood this. Now we will see the output of this program. So when I enter a number 345, I get the reverse number as 543. Hope you like this video. If you like it, please share and subscribe. Thank you.